thanks for tuning in to Christian Living Radio.
Christian Living Radio.
You are now listening to Christian Living Radio.
Welcome to Christian Living Radio with me, Dr. G. Hey, it's been a long time, but it's been a long time coming. How's that? I've missed everyone and made some moves, made some transitions, and I'm excited to get back to you and be a part of your life. I'm going to keep it short today and just share a few thoughts, you know, because we're all going through things continuously. If you're not going through something, you're not living. You're not living life. And it's important to know that you have a God to go to. And I want you to really, really let that soak in. Don't be afraid of what's going on in your life. Don't be afraid of the terrors by night, or nor the arrows that flyeth by day, right? These are the things that the Bible speaks to us about. And God wants you resting in Him and knowing who He is, because you are His child. And you should repeat that after me, that I am God's child. I am God's child. So that word, I am, really can set the tone for the rest of your day. And you need to do that each and every day, because and what you put after that, I am, will direct everything completely for the rest of the day. And I know you need that. So let's stand upon that, knowing that I am a child of God. So, you know, when I talk about not being afraid, there's things that pop up in our lives all the time. And some are distractions. Some are made to just take us off of our post or take our eye off of Christ. How about that? Because the enemy is constantly busy. We have bills coming up. They pile up. Fear sets in. We might think about losing our jobs, or, you know, losing a loved one, or that child that's gone astray, doing wild things. And the Lord still is right there with you in the midst of all of that. But you can't let fear direct your path. You can't let the bills direct your path. You can't let that child that's acting foolish and stupid and doing stupid things. Yes, I said stupid, because we've all been there. I was a stupid child one time. And I did many stupid things throughout my life. But praise be to God, I grew up and grew out of that. And so even things that hit us, that distract us or try to misguide us, right, could be a doctor's report. I remember when my neck, I had spinal stenosis through, and it all is caused from an earlier motorcycle accident. But I became paralyzed in the upper half of my body. And I couldn't understand what was going on. I couldn't understand why God was letting this happen to me. I couldn't understand why I had such a change coming on in my life, right? But the thing is I had to trust God that I was going to make it through. Even though the doctors were telling me that I only had a 30% chance of living through this surgery, I had to trust God that He had me in the palm of His hand, that He had my life, and I did not have to listen to what the doctors were saying, but I had to listen to what God was saying and what He was speaking over me. Because bad reports can really shift our thinking process and really throw us off our guard or off of our path that we were supposed to be walking, right? So I don't want you to be afraid. Now, that's easy to say, Dr. G. That's easy for you to say. You don't know what I'm going through. You're right. I don't, but you do. And God does. Above all things, God does. It doesn't matter what I think or what I know, but God knows it. Just like he knew me, right? And he came to me and told me in that surgery that, yea, though you walk through the valley of the shadows of death, I will be with you. So don't fear. And I told my wife, I'm going to make it. I'm going to be all right. But I heard the voice of God. I heard that talking to me and telling me these things. And now I'm walking, talking, doing things. My arms and limbs, you know, my mouth works now, which it didn't then, right? I couldn't move the right side. I lost feeling in my hand. All types of things went down to get me discouraged and off the path that God had led me to, right? So he'll hold you real, real tight in his mighty arms. He'll hold you and help you walk through. All you have to do is learn to trust. He'll be there to keep you in all your ways. But you've got to learn to trust God. Trust his word. How do you do that, you ask, right? Well, first of all, many of us don't read our Bibles. Many of you don't go to church, but only Sunday. And that's the only time you have communication with God. But he made us, created us, to have a relationship with him. So that means relationships mean that's somebody you talk to each and every day, throughout the day, not just once in a while, but throughout the day. You know, my first thing is wake up, I say thank you, you know, because I'm excited about what you got in store for me today, God. What's going to come up? What have you got for me that can help me help somebody else and change somebody else's life? And see, he'll give you peace even in the shadows of darkness. Sometimes you'll just be like, oh, I got a peace about that. Or I'm anxious about something. Well, maybe you shouldn't be doing that part of that thing. And that's another lesson I'll talk about at another date. But you want that peace that surpasses all understanding. And get rid of the worry, get rid of the anxieties of throughout life. So we don't want to panic, hit that panic button. Instead, we want to learn to rest in God's favor, his grace, his love, his compassion. When we turn to him, he'll give us the peace for the day, each and every time. Once we turn to him and say, Father, lead me. Father, guide me. Daddy, I need you right now. I don't know what to do. I don't know how to do things. Yeah, this child is acting up, or my job, my boss is acting up, or I got a coworker being evil towards me. Give it to God and let go. I'm going to give this to you today, Lord, because I can't do it. I need your help. And that's all he wants you to do. It's simple. Simple things will change your walk. So, you know, that's the biggest thing is he asks us, he tells us, he didn't ask us anything. He says, I'll take on the yoke. He might put the yoke on me, right? He's got the bigger shoulders. He's the broader one. He's the stronger one. Lean not onto your own understanding. But the book of Matthew talks, and it's funny because I had this prepared. And then one of my brothers, my spiritual brothers in Christ, sent me a text message about I'm resting. It's funny because that's how Holy Spirit works, right? You'll be on the same wavelength, same mental capacity because of what? God's love and being discipled by God, following God. It really does change things for us. So God is a gentle spirit. It says it's a still, quiet voice. But the biggest thing I'm talking to you about is just being blessed and trusting the Lord that you are already where you need to be. And he's going to work everything out. He's going to take care of that crazy kid. He's going to take care of that job. And sometimes we go through transitions. okay, where things happen. But he says, I'm going to use all things for your good. Everything's going to work out. Everything's going to be all right. Everything's going to be just fine. So I want you to trust that God's got you. And everything's going to work out. All right? Everything's going to work out. Matthew 11:29. Read that. Check it out. But of all things, I'm going to stand on another scripture. And that's Mark. It's found in Mark 11. Okay? And I'm going to read that scripture to you before I close out. And I just want to bless your life, because this is a staple scripture that I stand upon in my daily walk. And you know, you choose your own scripture to stand upon. I'm not telling you how to what scripture you got to pick, but I'm going to give you one of my staple scriptures to stand upon. And I can touch and agree with you right now over these airwaves, wherever you're at, whatever country you're in, and just stand by that faith. Okay. So Matthew 11:22, we're going to start at 22. And it says, this is after he's cursed a fig tree. If you remember the fig tree withering away. So Jesus answered and said to them, have faith in God. For assuredly I say to you, whoever says to this mountain, be removed and cast thyself into the sea, and does not doubt in his heart, but believes those things he says will be done, he will have whatever he says. Boy, that's a key right there. Don't doubt. Trust God. Don't doubt. Trust God. 24 says, I'm going into 24. Therefore, I say to you, whatever things you ask when you pray, believe that you receive them and you will have them. I'm Dr. G. That's the word for the day. God bless you, and may his best be yours. We'll talk to you soon. We'll see you next time here, right back here on Christian Living Radio with me, Dr. G. God bless. Christian Living Radio, Christian Living Radio. Let this mind be in you that was in Jesus too. Thought it not robbery to be equal with God. I hunger and I starve. Sometimes it gets so hard when you're back on the wall, but he done paid it all. My Christian living walk, this Christian living dog. We do this for the kingdom, yeah, we taking charge. You can ask Kiana, gon' ask Roberta. Ain't nothing that's gon' stop us from serving Satan murder. Drawing closer to God, putting the flesh aside. For Yahshua we ride, for Yahshua we die. Something I can't deny, put that on everything. God over everything, do not be conformed. You cannot stay the same, you gotta be transformed. Gon' renew your mind, Christ lives inside of me. Word to my inner man, we Christian living man. Word to my inner man, this Christian living man. Christian living radio, Christian living radio, Christian living radio.